Hey guys, Kronegger here.
In this series, we talk about games that have been presented in the main games. Borderlands 1, Borderlands 2, Borderlands 3, and Borderlands the pre-sequel. Let's talk about the volcano and see how it has changed. The volcano was in Maliwan a sniper, and in Borderlands 1, all the snipers had a 150% crit damage bonus. The red text, PELE DEMANDS A SACRIFICE. It's a reference to PELE, a Hawaiian volcano goddess. The volcano also had a 100% chance to ignite enemies and a high damage over time, which was a deadly, very deadly combination. And like a wise man once said,
"Is shooting bullets just not cool enough for you? Get a Maliwan and light some people on fire!"
The volcano created incendiary explosions that could hit multiple enemies at once, and remember that in Borderlands 1, incendiary splash damage was a damage multiplier based on your weapon damage. So basically, depending on the procs, the volcano could deal up to 3.2 times its weapon damage when you hit an enemy. The combination of all the things I just mentioned made the volcano one of the best snipers in the game. In Borderlands 2, it has a classic Maliwan skin, although this time it looks like it's been charred, which is pretty fitting, if you ask me. Snipers now have a 100% crit damage bonus, less than in Borderlands 1. The volcano ignite chance got reduced to 50%, the fire rate got increased a little bit, it still does splash damage, and also the red text is again a PELE reference. Oh, by the way, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that name correctly, but yeah. The red text is pretty much the same as in Borderlands 1, but this time it's a much more polite request, and it kinda describes how this weapon changed from Borderlands 1 to Borderlands 2. I mean, technically this is a viable weapon, but it is outperformed by everything else. I mean, yes, you can make it work on Axton since the volcano does splash damage, and Axton can boost that type of damage. But besides that, every other bow hunter is better off using a sniper or a pimpernel, even Axton. So the volcano in Borderlands 2, well, it's a nice looking sniper. In Borderlands, the pre-sequel is now called the Magma, with the red text, liquid hot. It still has the same skin, same ignite chance, same 80% splash damage boosted by grenade bonuses, and it is a good sniper here. Aurelia, even Claptrap, can make a really good use of this sniper. Also, I wanna point out a new mechanic that was introduced in Borderlands the pre-sequel, and that is vacuum areas, which means that there is no oxygen, and which also means that you cannot apply incendiary damage over time, because fire requires oxygen to burn. It's a very realistic feature for a non-realistic game, but yeah, anyways, it's a really good sniper in this game. In Borderlands 3, we got the Krakatoa, a Maliwan sniper with the red text,
"Get him angry and he's bound to erupt! Krakatoa!"
This time you cannot set people on fire, and the bullets do not do splash damage. And I know it might sound a bit different to the volcano we know, but hey, the name is a volcano reference, the red text is a volcano reference, the ability literally spawns a volcano, so yeah, it's the spiritual successor. I might be wrong here, but I remember this weapon always being good, even before it got buffed. Although, it is underrated by a lot of people, and I think it's mainly because with the addition of more and more content, we got much stronger snipers. And yeah, this is not a meta weapon, however, it is a really good sniper. It got even higher fire rate than its predecessor, which combined with being full auto, it's just amazing. Also, the mini volcano shoots out fireballs that deal splash damage, and you can create some stupidly strong combinations with this. I don't know, there is something about this gun that feels pretty good when you use it. I genuinely like it. But what about you? What's your favorite version of the volcano? Let me know in the comment sections. I'll see you there, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.